In this video, we're talking about stoichiometry. Well, stoichiometry, if you break down the meaning of the word, means the measuring elements. It comes, I believe, from the Greek. What it really means for us is it talks about the practice of using the coefficients in a balanced equation to determine quantities about other species in a balanced chemical equation in a chemical reaction. And the way that these coefficients do that is that when we have a balanced equation, the coefficients give us conversion factors. Now, we're definitely talking about dimensional analysis here. Almost all stoichiometry problems that you'll do will be dimensional analysis problems. So we're still going to be using that whole method that we learned back at the beginning of the course. For example, let's look at this balanced chemical equation. I already balanced it for you. And this stuff is methanol, by the way, CH3OH. And when it's balanced, we have two methanols reacting with three oxygens to make two carbon dioxides and four water molecules. And so we know that the coefficients tell us that two molecules of methanol react with three molecules of oxygen to make two molecules of carbon dioxide and four molecules of water. We also know that we can interpret those coefficients as moles. We can read this as saying, and it's true, that two moles of methanol react with three moles of oxygen and produce two moles of carbon dioxide and four moles of water. Now, that's where we get our conversion factors. So I listed all the conversion factors that you can get from this balanced equation. And you'll never have to write all of the conversion factors down. For every problem that we're doing, you're just going to need one of these. And you can read it. Once you've done this, just a couple of these problems, you'll be able to just look at a balanced chemical equation and read the conversion factor off right from the coefficients. But I thought I'd show it to you so that you know where we're getting this stuff. So the 2 and the 3 here tells us that as a conversion factor, we know that for this particular reaction, 2 moles of methanol is equal to 3 moles of oxygen. Or we could read this as reacting with 3 moles of oxygen. We also know that 2 moles of methanol is equal to 2 moles of carbon dioxide, or 2 moles of methanol produce 2 moles of carbon dioxide. Now, we could reduce this to 1 and 1. It's the same as the ratio. It's a ratio, really. It's 1 to 1 or 2 to 2. I kept the 2s here because that's the numbers that you guys see up here as coefficients, so you know where they came from. Okay, so we also know that 2 moles of methanol is equal to, produces 4 moles of water. Here, 2 to 4. And then we know that 3 moles of oxygen is equal to or produces 2 moles of carbon dioxide. 3 moles of oxygen is equal to 4 moles of water, produces 4 moles of water. And 2 moles of carbon dioxide is equal to, produces 4 moles of water. So we know all of that just from looking at a balanced equation. Now, when you're using these coefficients as conversion factors, you'll just look up the two molecules that you're interested in and get the conversion factor directly from there, like 3 to 2 for oxygen to carbon dioxide, for example. So let's use these in a problem. So we want to know how many moles of oxygen we need to react with 7.39 moles of methanol. And we're, same balanced equation, but I gave it to you. There it is. And so now, because now that we know what molecules we care about, oxygen and methanol, from the word problem, we can pick out our conversion factor right away. 2 moles of methanol is equal to 3 moles of oxygen. We can convert between moles of methanol and moles of oxygen. Now, when you're doing the dimensional analysis problems, the word problems that you will be doing in stoichiometry, the only connection that you guys will have between two different molecules will be the mole-to-mole ratio, we call this, or the conversion factor from the balanced chemical equation. So we have that. Now we're going to set up follow our normal dimensional analysis procedure. We want to know how many moles of oxygen. So the units of our answer will be moles of oxygen. We put a blank in there in front of that. So our goal is to fill in this blank, right? And our starting point, or how many moles of oxygen in what? Well, react with 7.39 moles of methanol. So 7.39 moles of methanol is our starting point. And our conversion factor, we wrote down here, converts between moles of oxygen and moles of methanol. And so we know that because we have moles of methanol in the top here, in the numerator, we must have moles of methanol in the denominator. So that lets us know to put the 2 moles of methanol in the bottom. The other side of the equal sign goes in the numerator, in the top. And we have this, right? And so now cross out our units, right? So the moles of methanol cancel like this. We're left with moles of oxygen. And our answer is 11.08 moles of oxygen, 3 sig figs because of this. The coefficients, by the way, in a balanced chemical equation are exact numbers. So the 2 and the 3, the 2 and the 4 are exact. And so we round to 3 sig figs, 11.1 moles of oxygen.